Now let's move on to Karaka. Karaka means the one that is associated with an action. Okay, so words associated with an action is called as Karaka. Now let's take a word like an action word like gives. Does it make any sense? Of course not. A lot of questions pop up in your mind, like what gives, who gives, when gives, where gives. All these questions come to your mind. Now look at that picture that I have given there. And looking at this picture, I say Raja gives, and then you understand, right? Raja gives, it makes sense. So Raja there is the doer of the action, okay, and he is, and that action is known as Kartakaraka. Okay, so Kartakaraka means Karta means agent, the doer of the action. Raja gives. So I told you what Karaka is. Karaka is the one which is associated with an action. So the first one is Kartakaraka. Now let's check what Karmakaraka is. Now I take a look at the same picture, and we will be asking another question like what gives. The king gives what? And the answer is the king gives gold. So the gold there becomes the object of the action gives, and it is known as Karma Karaka. The third one is Karnakaraka. Now, I ask the question, the king gives gold with what? And the answer is, the king gives gold with his hands. So the hands become the instrument for the action. And therefore, it is known as the Karnakaraka, the instrument of the action. The next one is Sampradana Karaka. Now, Sampradana means to bestow. Whom does Raja give? The answer is Raja gives to the Brahmin. So whom does he bestow? He bestows gold to the Brahmin. So Sampradana, to bestow. The next one, Apadana Karaka. Now, suppose he has taken this gold, the king or Raja has taken the gold from his treasury. So from where did he take the gold? The answer is from the treasury. It shows the separation from the treasury to the king. So to show separation, you have the Apadana Karaka. Okay. The next one is Adhikarana Karaka. Adhikarana Karaka. Now, where does king give? Okay. The answer is simple. He gives it from his palace. Okay. So, Adhikarana Karaka shows us the location. Now, all these words are associated with the action gives. So, these are the different cases in Sanskrit, and they have their equivalent in English grammar as well. We shall be discussing about that, but I hope these cases are quite clear to you. The first one, Kartakaraka, second, Karmakaraka, third, Karanakaraka, fourth, Sampradanakaraka, fifth, Apadanakaraka, and sixth, the Adhikarana Karaka. Now let's talk about let's discuss the theoretical part of it. So what do you mean by Karaka? Karaka this is the definition. Basic semantic notions that pivot sentence constructions, meaning these are the different case forms, and it is based on these case forms that all sentence constructions depend on. So they are similar to the case role proposed in the case grammar. In English, you have the case roles. Let's talk about these case roles in detail. So Panini identifies six karakas and they correspond to six cases in English. For example, the nominative case, the acquisitive case, the dative case, instrumental case, locative case, as well as the ablative case. Let's talk about the apadana first. Apadana means to take off. Literally means from where the departure takes place. Remember the picture? I told you apadana means from where. I told you the king or Raja took the gold from the treasury. So from where, that is what it means. From where the departure takes place. Okay, its equivalent in English is the ablative notion. I have an example there to provide you. They sailed from Greece to Italy. They sailed from Greece to Italy. So from is used to show from where the departure took place. So in English, you do not have suffixes as such. Therefore, you use prepositions to show suffixes. Whereas in Indian languages, you have suffixes or vibhaktis to show these cases. Okay, to show the apadana or what is known as ablative notion in English. For example, it will be like our Greece il ninnu Italyilekku yathra thirichu. So Greece il ninnu, you have these suffixes to show the apadana. And the next one is sampradana. Sampradana, I have told you, to whom the gold is given. Raja gave gold to the Brahmin. So it means he whom one aims at with the object. In English, it is equivalent to the dative notion. We give a bone to our dog. Okay. Yangal pattikku ellu koduthu. Pattikku is the vibhakti there to show sampradana. The next one is karana, means instrument. This is equivalent to the instrumental notion in English. For example, I wrote the note with a pen. So see, there you have used the preposition with to show the instrumental notion. In Malayalam, if you take the sentence, it will be Nyan pena konda ezhuthi. So the suffix there is konda allengil. Nyan penayal ezhuthi. There you use yal to show the suffix. The next one, adhikarana. Adhikarana is equivalent to the locative notion. It shows the location. I sat on the chair. Or I can say, Nyan kasereyil irunu. Nyan kallil irunu. So you use il to show location. The next one is karma karaka. It is equivalent to the acquisitive notion. Okay, the object, that is what it means. I told you the Brahmin gave what? The Brahmin gave, sorry, the Raja gave what? Raja gave gold. That was our answer. So here, the dog ate what? The answer is our turkey. That is what is known as the karma karaka. Now karta karaka. Karta karaka means the agent, the subject, that is equivalent to the nominative notion. okay, that is independent in action. It can stand on its own. Okay, I drafted a poem. So I is the agent. That is the nominative notion. In Malayalam, I can give another sentence like Raman Sidaye Kandu. Raman. It can stand on its own, right? It's not Ramane, Ramande. There is no suffix there. It stands on its own. That is the Kartakaraka. Okay? So, with that, we have finished the Karakas. And let's check once again what Vibhakti is. Vibhaktis are case endings. So, I told you, they are suffixes which are added to the words, and when suffixes are added, it changes the meaning of the words. So these suffixes cannot stand on its own, or vibhaktis cannot stand on its own. It makes sense only when it is added to, or when they come along with the word. And each case ending will have a distinct meaning which is not expressed by other case endings. For example, I say Ramende. Ramende pena. So inte has got a definite meaning. But then when I say Ramanal kollapettu, so nal there has another meaning. Okay, so inte, il, all these are different suffixes that are used in a particular context to show whether it is the agent, or whether it is the subject, or whether it is the instrument, or whatever it is. So to show the all these cases, they have, or we have, different case endings which are known as vibhaktis, and these cases are what is known as karaka. Okay, I hope these terms are quite clear to you, karaka as well as vibhakti. Okay, so do listen to this video again, and if you have any doubts regarding karaka or vibhakti, do comment in the notification section, and we shall be discussing more on this topic. Thank you so much for your patient listening. We shall meet once again in our next video. Till then, bye. Thank you.